हरिओम। इन कंटिन्यूशन टू द प्रीवियस वीडियो ऑन डेटा माइनिंग एंड डेटा वेयर हाउसिंग कोर्स, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस डिसीशन ट्रीज हियर। द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी टॉक्ड अबाउट व्हाट इज द बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन सुपरवाइज्ड लर्निंग एंड अनसुपरवाइज्ड लर्निंग ऑफ मशीन लर्निंग एल्गोरिदम्स। Then we discussed what is classification, what are the two steps of classification process we discussed. So from the training data we derive the classification algorithm that gives the model or the set of rules. And the second step is used for estimating the accuracy of classification rules, for which we use the test data. If the accuracy is an acceptable date value, then we can use this model for predicting the class of a new object. As already discussed, decision tree is a type of data mining technique which is used to build the classification models that comes under supervised learning. The decision tree builds the classification models in the form of a tree-like structure, that is why the term decision tree. The decision trees can be used both for categorical and numerical data. When I say categorical data, it represents the data like gender, marital status, etc. Whereas the numerical data represent the data like age, temperature, salary, etc. The decision tree is a classification scheme that generates a tree and a set of rules from the given data set. And these set of rules represent the model of different classes. That is the application of decision tree. So we can say it is a classification scheme which will generate a tree-like structure and also a set of rules from the given data set. And this given data set is what we call as training data. We call it as training data. And these set of rules represent the model of different classes available in the given data set. Now, these set of records, this data set, the given data set is what we call as the set of records. So, the given data set or the set of records will be divided into two disjoint subsets. One is called as training data, the other one is called as test data, or you call it as training set and the test set. So the training set is again a subset of the given set of records, and this training set is used to derive the classifier. So the training set is the one which is used for deriving the classifier or the model to classify. Whereas the test data is used to measure the accuracy of the derived classifier. So using the training set, we have derived the classifier. We have to test whether the classifier is accurate or not. So for measuring the accuracy of this classifier, we can use the test data. And generally, the accuracy will be determined by the percentage of the test examples that are correctly classified. So suppose, say for example, if I have 100 records, 80 records can be used as the training set and 20 records can be used as test data, right? Or 75 records can be used as the training set and 25 records can be used as the test data. So in general, if you have a set of records or the data set, 80% of the data set will be used for training set and 20% of the data set will be used for the test set, or 75% of the data set will be the training data, and 25% of the data set can be used for the test data, right? So if I am going to use out of 100 records, I am using 20 records. Let us assume I am using 20 records for the test set. And if the accuracy is 100%, all the 20 records have been classified correctly, then the accuracy will be 100%. Whereas out of 20 records, only 10 records have been classified correctly using this model, then we can say the accuracy is only 50%. Okay. Or if 15%, right? If 15 records have been classified correctly, then we can say 75% is the accuracy of this particular model. So that is how the accuracy will be determined. So the accuracy is determined by the percentage of the test examples that are correctly classified. Now, to implement the decision tree, the attributes of the records, the set of records, right? So we use the set of records for building the model. We have seen for building the classification model, we have seen here, right? So for building the classifier, we will be using the training set, right? So this training set is what you call as the data set of records, and this set of records will have three types of attributes. One is called as numerical attributes, categorical attributes, and the third one is class label. Let us see an example. Suppose if this is the given data set, then for this given data set, this is called as the numerical attribute, and these are all called as categorical attributes, and the last label, which is a distinguished attribute, which you call as the class label. So this is the one that specify whether this record falls into this class label or this class label. So this is the one which you call as the label of these set of records. So I can say this is a labeled data set, because decision tree is a classification scheme. Classification scheme is coming under supervised learning, and supervised learning uses only the labeled data. So since it uses only the labeled data, all these set of records will have the last attribute as the class label. This is another example of the data set where the first one will be the numerical attribute, and all these are the categorical attributes, and the last one is the class label. So again, I can say this is a labeled data set. So any decision tree, if you want to implement, then the set of records must have these three kinds of attributes: numerical attribute, or it can have categorical attribute, but it must have a class label. So it can have all these attributes can be numerical attributes, or all these attributes can be categorical attributes, but the last attribute must be a class label. So this must be a class label. Therefore, we can say a decision tree is a flowchart-like tree structure where each internal node, this is an example of a decision tree. So each internal node denotes a test on an attribute, and each branch represents an outcome of the test, and each leaf node holds a class label. Okay? So this is the root node of the decision tree. These are all internal nodes. So the root node will also behave as a internal node. These are all internal nodes. Okay. and these branches are the outcome. So if age less than or equal to 30, it comes here, and if student no, and I think I'm really very sorry. Here these are the branches, okay, these are, this yellow color are the branches and these are the internal nodes. Kindly make the correction. The branches, these are the branches, these are the branches, and this is the internal node. This blue color, student, these are all the internal nodes. This question mark, so wherever you see question mark, these are all internal nodes, right? Please make this correction. This is the root node and not this one. This is a branch actually. This is a branch, and this question mark nodes are the internal nodes, and this is again a branch, and below that we will have the leaf node. Or I think this is a better example. This is a better example. Don't take this example for these things. I'm really very sorry. You must correct it. What you have to understand is the decision tree is a flowchart like tree structure, and it will have a root node, it will have a branch, it will have an internal node, and it will have the leaf node also, right? Let us take this example. This is better example. This is the root node, and these are the branches, these are the branches, and this is again an internal node, and this is the leaf node, right? I think let me make the correction here itself. Now itself I will make the correction. Is the internal node, this is going to be the leaf node, and this is the branch, okay, and here in the leaf node we will have the class label. Whether he buys the computer or not. So here we can say he will not buy the computer. Kindly bear with me. Let me make this correction in our document. Okay, so this is how it comes. Let me copy all these. This is the leaf node. Okay, so now this is better. This example will be better for you. Okay, so I got it corrected. Okay, so now it's fine. So we can say decision tree is a flowchart like tree structure where each internal node, so this root node is also an internal node, this is an internal node, this is an internal node, this is an internal node. So the internal node denotes a test condition on a particular attribute. So here it is a test condition for the attribute called age. This is the test condition for the attribute called student, and this is a test condition for attribute called credit rating. Okay, and the branch represent an outcome of the test. So whether the age value is less than or equal to 30, age is between 31 to 40, age is greater than 40. So this is what you call as the branch, the outcome of the test condition. Or whether the credit rating is excellent or the credit rating is fair. So this shows the branch, and the leaf node holds the class label, right? So the class label here is yes or no. So the class label will be the leaf node. The same way for this particular data set, this is a decision tree. You can see here, this is again a tree-like structure. The root node and the internal nodes are showing the test condition on a particular attribute, outlook, wind, humidity. These are the attributes I have. So the internal nodes represent the attributes, and the branch shows the outcome of the test condition. So if the outlook value is sunny, then this is one outcome. If the outlook value is overcast, outlook value is rain, or whether the wind is strong or weak. So these branches shows the outcome of the test condition. Then the leaf node shows the class label. The leaf node shows the class label. So this is what you call as the decision tree structure. And here in the decision tree, a path is traced from the root node to the leaf node, which holds the class prediction for a new object. So obviously the path is a rule which is used to classify the record. Okay, so when I say the path, this can be called as one path. This can be called as one path. So what it says, if the age is less than or equal to 30 and student is equal to no. Student is equal to no. I think let me correct here. And student equal to no, then buys the computer becomes the no value. That means he will not buy a computer. So that is what it shows here as the rule for. Okay, so you can observe here the path will be right from the root node to the leaf node, and it holds the class prediction for a new object. So when a new object comes in, the value will be checked. If the value of the new age value of the new object is less than or equal to 30 and the student value is equal to no, then the conclusion can be he will not buy a computer. Or if you take this particular decision tree, if outlook is sunny and humidity is high, then don't play. No. So this can be one of the rule which will be classification rule which will be derived from this decision tree. Okay. So a path is the one that gives you a classification rule. This rule can be used to classify the record. So generally the path will be traced from the root node to the leaf node, and that holds the class prediction for a new object. So we have now seen what is the decision tree and what is the structure of the decision tree. What do you mean by a path in the decision tree? Next, very important two concepts of decision tree. What do you mean by a splitting attribute and what do you mean by a splitting criteria? So splitting attribute, with every node of the decision tree, there is an associated attribute whose values determine the partitioning of the data set when the node is expanded. Okay, so if you see here, the splitting attribute is outlook. So using this outlook, with every node of the decision tree, every internal node of the decision tree, there is an associated attribute. Obviously, here the associated attribute is outlook, associated attribute is humidity, associated attribute is wind. There is an associated attribute whose values determine the partitioning of the data set. So what happens here? This is the attribute and whose value. If the value is sunny, a set of records will be partitioned here. If the value is overcast, set of values will be partitioned here. If the value is rain, set of records will be partitioned here. So if you see, the splitting attribute for this decision tree are outlook, humidity and wind. So if the outlook is equal to sunny, then these records 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 records will be partitioned here. If the outlook value is overcast, how many records will come there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 records will come into this particular set or in this particular partition. If it is equal to rain, how many records? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This many records will come here. So that is what it says. Partitioning of the data set. The value determine the partitioning of the data set when the node is expanded. So when you expand these nodes, it will be partitioning the data based on these values. So out of 14 records, the 5 sunny records come here and 4 overcast records come here and 5 rain records come here. That is what you call as splitting attribute. So with every internal node of the decision tree, there is an associated attribute whose value determine the partitioning of the data set. So these are called as splitting attributes and their values determine the partitioning of the records of the given data set. So here these are the splitting attributes and here age, student, credit rating are the splitting attributes. And the splitting criteria is the condition, right? So what is the qualifying condition on the splitting attribute for the data set? So that splitting at a node is called a splitting criterion at that particular node. Now the qualifying condition, if you take, it depends on the type of the attribute. If the attribute is a numerical attribute, then the qualifying condition will be an equation or inequality. So you will say whether age is equal to 45, whether age is greater than or equal to 30, or whether age is less than or equal to 40, like that you will be specifying the numeric attribute condition as equation or inequation. Whereas if it is going to be a categorical attribute, it is going to be a membership condition on a subset of values. But for example, for the outlook, the three values are sunny, overcast and rain. So for this splitting criteria, you will say if outlook is a member of this particular set. So this is a subset. Actually, the set of values are sunny, overcast and rain. These are the three possible values for outlook. Okay. Now the subset can be sunny, subset can be overcast, subset can be rain. So if the outlook value belongs to any of this subset, wind value belongs to this particular subset. So this kind of condition, membership condition, you will use for the categorical attribute. And you may be thinking like, why can't we use the equation itself, right? Outlook is equal to sunny, outlook is equal to weak. Instead of that, what we do, suppose if I want to have two values, sunny and weak, then sorry, sunny and overcast. So you will say outlook value is a member of sunny comma overcast. That is why we call it as the membership condition and not the equality condition. Okay, so here for this given example, the splitting criteria for this can be said as outlook belongs to sunny set, or humidity belongs to high. It is not high or normal. It can be high. It can be high, or it can be normal. You can't have both here. So if you have both here, all the 14 records will come into one partition. You can't have both here. You can have either high or normal, since I have only two values. Whereas if I have three or four values, you can have high and normal here. Then say for example medium, high, normal, then low. Suppose if you have low, then I can have high and normal in one set, low in another set. That is possible. But since I have only two values here, you cannot have humidity belongs to high and normal. Both here cannot be. You can have either high or normal. But if you have more than two values, you can go for as two or three values in a subset, right? So this is what we call as a splitting criteria. Now here in this case, age greater than 40. Greater than 40 can be one splitting criteria. Student, no, is another splitting criteria. A credit rating, fair, belongs to fair, can be one criteria. Like that you can have different criterias. Right, so here again let me correct it. You cannot have both high and normal here because we have only two values, so obviously you must have it as high or normal. And here you can have credit rating belongs to fair. Okay, so this can be another set of values. I'm correcting all these things. So all these things you have to correct again. So this is how your splitting criteria should look like. Okay, your splitting attributes are these and splitting criteria is this, right? And kindly make a note of it, and this has to be corrected. I have corrected here, right? I have corrected here. So in the same way, please do correct it here also, right? Don't take it as it is, and the the marking is wrong here. So I made the correction here. In this slide I made the correction, and these corrections should also come here in this example and as well as in this example. So please do that correction also, right? So these are the basics of decision tree that we should understand. Let us see how to construct the decision tree in the upcoming video. Thank you.